these little jars, I have caught about a dozen of fruit flies from my own home. In this large 10-liter jar, I have placed two different species of plant, Coffea arabica and Irisine herbaceae, not from my own home, but from the garden center. In this large jar, I placed a single banana peel, yellow. Then I made a banana beer yeast smoothie, which I put inside this syringe in order to put it in the jar. I felt kinda bad about this because, you know, syringes have feelings as well. And then I added the smoothie to the jar. While you look at that in close detail, let me explain why I'm doing all this. Back when I was a little human, as you guys know, I totally used to be one of those, I once put a lot of fruit flies in a bottle with an old banana peel. Then I forgot about it for a week, saw a lot of weird white worms and totally freaked out, not knowing they were larvae. When I saw fruit flies in my house, like every summer, I decided that I wanted to try and replicate the experiment, but with a twist. This time I wanted to try and breed fruit flies in an airtight jar, where oxygen is provided to the flies by the plants and carbon dioxide is provided to the plants by the fruit flies. There is, hopefully, enough banana beer yeast smoothie present to support many, many generations. This is a closed ecosystem that will not live on forever, but we'll see how long it can last. The next step is to add the fruit flies. I put them in the freezer to temporarily render them unconscious, which works because they are cold-blooded animals. That way, I could put them in the jar without them all flying away. I tried not to throw them in the smoothie, but as you can see, I haven't been entirely successful. As they're starting to warm up again, they are regaining their consciousness. There's quite a few in here, more than enough to start a large colony. And that's pretty much the entire building process. The very next day, despite all the moisture on the glass, we can clearly see flies flying around. This is not the first time I've had flying insects in one of my closed ecosystems, but it is the first time I deliberately made a windowsill aviary. So seeing flying flies in the jar put a smile on my face. Only 2 days later, there's already mold growing on the smoothie and the smoothie runoff water, which I was hoping the yeast would help prevent, or at least delay. However, I don't think the flies nor their larvae will really be bothered by it. To keep the fruit fly population in check and make sure they don't use up all their resources really quickly, a natural enemy should be present in the form of a spider. I did not add one myself, but at least one was present in the soil. Now, I doubt the spider will really prey on fruit flies, it's probably too tiny. But it's an interesting addition and we'll keep an eye on it. I'm not 100% sure whether the species of fruit fly in this jar is Drosophila melanogaster or Drosophila funebris. Both are very common in the Netherlands and I have no experience in telling them apart. However, I think this is Drosophila melanogaster. I also really hope it is because I had this species in mind when creating the smoothie. After 4 days, the two patches of mold had grown in size again, and quite a lot. The smoothie got completely covered in mold as well, and the banana peel started to turn black. After 6 days, I noticed that the plants were wilting. So I decided to open the jar and water the plants, which I could do because there were now lots of larvae and pupae present in the jar, meaning that, even if somehow all the adult fruit flies escaped, the jar would be filled with fruit flies again in a matter of days. One day later, we already have a freshly hatched young fruit fly. You can tell it just hatched because the wings are still stuck together. Right next to it is an even younger fruit fly, still a larva. Here's another freshly hatched fruit fly, with the wings still stuck together on top of the black banana peel. We can see that after only a day, the amount of pupae has increased by a lot. I'm not sure if this is the same spider as we saw before, or if it's a different one, but regardless, there's still at least one living spider in the jar. The only larvae I've been able to show you so far are the really big and white larvae, in their final stages of being larvae. The smaller larvae are actually quite hard to find, but here on this banana peel they can be found munching away. And although this was quite hard to film, and they're difficult to see, you do get a better sense of the complete life cycle of this small flying insect. While I was filming this, a fruit fly that I hadn't caught and put inside the jar decided that this very jar would be as good a place as any to just sit and be a fruit fly. 9 days after this fruit fly jar was made, the irisine herbstii is definitely going to die. It has lost all of its color in the leaves and it's starting to lose color in the stems. There's also fungus growing on the leaves. So yeah, it's a done deal. A few very small new leaves are growing at the base, so maybe, just maybe, this species will survive. But the Coffea arabica should be able to do all of the plant work in this ecosystem on its own. Even though there's fungus growing on some of its stems, I have high hopes that this plant will be able to survive in here. I actually have Coffea arabica still alive in a 2.5 years old closed terrarium. 2 days later, 11 days after the fruit fly jar was made, we are seeing the beginning of the fruit fly baby boom. I think I'll end this video on this exciting note, but don't worry, we will see more of this project in the future. I would like to thank Aaron Croydon and Juliana Martinez, or is it Juliana Martinez? Sorry. As well as the 97 other patrons for their generous support. If you would like to see other projects and don't want to miss updates on the fruit fly jar, and you haven't already, well, you're going to have to subscribe. Thanks for watching, and fruit fly.